fighter named Dwight Braxton won the WBC Light Heavyweight World Championship on a 10th round technical knockout of Matthew Saad Muhammad. Braxton later lost that title to Michael Spinks, but under his Muslim name of Dwight Muhammad Qawi, he moved up to the junior heavyweight class and last year captured the WBA title by knocking out champion Piet Kraus. Leon Spinks was a member of the 1976 American Olympic boxing team, Olympic gold medalist on this third round knockout of Cuban Sisto Soria. In only his eighth bout as a professional, he upset the odds to win the heavyweight title from Muhammad Ali. But Leon couldn't handle the pressure of holding the heavyweight crown, and he lost it back to Ali in a rematch. That was 1978, and Spinks has been trying to rebuild his career since that point. Last year brought five straight victories, including this eighth-round stoppage of Kip Kane, to put him in line for today's title fight, an opportunity Spinks almost missed. At the initial weigh-in, just 2 hours before this would have been declared a non-title fight, Leon was nearly 2 pounds over the 190-pound limit. He finally made weight with just 20 minutes to spare after running around a nearby lake. So today, live from Reno, Nevada, the WBA Junior Heavyweight Title Confrontation. Champion, Dwight Muhammad Qawi versus challenger, Leon Spinks. A look at the majestic Sierra Nevada mountains surrounding Reno, Nevada. Site today of this WBA Junior Light Heavyweight Championship fight between Dwight Muhammad Qawi and Leon Spinks. We are inside the Lawlor Event Center on the campus of the University of Nevada at Reno for this World Junior Heavyweight Championship fight. Hello, I'm Jim Lampley. Before we get to the details of this particular fight, first, a moment of sympathy. This past Thursday, boxing lost a rising star. 26-year-old middleweight contender James Shuler of Philadelphia perished in a motorcycle accident in his hometown. On this particular weekend, all of us at ABC Sports extend our sympathy and condolences to the family and friends of James Shuler. All right, now more on this title fight. First, a word about the very existence of this division. There is considerable debate in boxing circles whether or not this division should exist. Called by two federations, the cruiserweight division, and with the limit at 195 pounds, here called junior heavyweight with the limit at 190 pounds. Those who believe that it shouldn't exist say that these fighters are either light heavyweights or heavyweights and should fight in one of those two divisions. Those who say it should say that because of the size of the modern athlete, it's necessary to have this intermediate division so that 190 and 195 pound fighters don't match up against 220 and 230 pound fighters. Suffice to say that the two fighters you'll see today are the most glamorous and charismatic yet to compete in this division. Yesterday we spoke to both of them, and first we asked the champion what he thought of today's challenger.
He's qualified. He's qualified. He's for real, you know. He's for real in his own mind, at least. And that's what counts, you know, because I'm not going to make him any better than what he is. My job is to make him less. And more than anything, cut that time short.
How do you plan to do that?
Take it right straight to him.
Well, I will not tell you how I'm going to beat him. But I think Qawi is a man just trying to, he got something, he's trying to hold on to it. And I can respect him for that. But he just got something that I want, and I'm going all out to get it.
Spinks and Qawi will be entering the ring here. Gold medalist in 64. Now let's go back to that January night in Kingston, Jamaica, and pick up Howard Cosell's call in round one.
There's another left by George. He's getting into Frazier's head. We'll find out tonight how much the Ali fight took out of Frazier, if anything. And we'll find out tonight just how good George Foreman is in punching and in taking a punch. I think he hurt Joe Frazier. I think Joe is hurt. Angie Dundee, Ali's trainer right next to me, is saying it. You may hear him. Down goes Frazier! Down goes Frazier! Down goes Frazier! The heavyweight champion is taking the mandatory eight count, and Foreman is as poised as can be in a neutral corner. He is as poised as can be. We have a minute left in this first round, and already this fight is proving out what some have expected. Oh, that left is getting in there. Underneath, Archie Moore is yelling to Foreman. We've got the excitement here that we look for. Frazier is dazed. He is getting hit again and again and again. The same head that was hit so often by Muhammad Ali. Frazier is dazed. You see the countdown for the first round. Foreman has not panicked. Foreman is going about his job. Foreman is all over Joe Frazier. Frazier is down again, and he may be. No, he is rising. He is game. He doesn't know where he is. The mandatory eight count. He doesn't know where he is. Now the round is about to end. Two knockdowns in the first round of Joe Frazier. Down again. No saving by the bell. He's up, and so the fight continues. Three knockdowns in the first round by George Foreman.
Round two promised more of the same as Foreman came in to finish the job.
Oh, he is all over Frazier again. He has Frazier in the corner. Frazier's knees buckled. He is down for the fourth time in the fight. George Foreman is doing the Joe Frazier what he did as a 19-year-old to a veteran Russian, a fellow named Ioannis Chapoulas, in October of 1968 in the Mexico City Arena. A quick left from George. Another. Frazier is down for the fifth time in this fight. Fifth time. Three times in the first round, twice in the second. McCanny checked his senses. Check Frazier's senses. Right. It's target practice for George Foreman. It is target practice. Frazier is ready to go again. Joe is standing. There he goes. Three times. Three times. The fight is stopped. No, it is not. It is not stopped. Angie Dundee is screaming, stop it. Ferdy Pacheco, Ali's doctor next to me. It is over. It is over. It is over in the second round. George Foreman is the heavyweight champion of the world.
Hard work. For almost 3.5 years, I had worked as hard as I could. And then to go on to win the professional heavyweight championship of the world, for the first time I knew I could be a role model. I was on a platform that the whole world could see that a former alcoholic street fighter could make something out of his life. And that fight provided me with a platform to kind of tell the old American story about George Foreman.
One quarter of a century of sports history.
Back to the Lawlor Events Center in Reno, both fighters, Dwight Muhammad Qawi and Leon Spinks, in the ring behind us. Now with our boxing expert, Alex Wallow. Fascinating to me, Alex, that you have one fighter, Qawi, who once won a world title at 175 pounds. Another, Leon Spinks, who once won a world championship at over 200 pounds. They meet in the middle at 190.
Well, I think, Jim, the story of this fight really is how well Qawi and Spinks are able to retain those qualities that made them champions in the other weight divisions. Of course, Dwight Muhammad Qawi has had several fights as a junior heavyweight. Indeed, he won the title at this weight. But he has not yet shown that competitive peak carrying the extra weight that he did as the light heavyweight champion of the world. As for the challenger, Leon Spinks, who's being introduced in the ring behind me right now, in his last fight 3 months ago, Leon weighed 213 pounds, the most he's ever weighed in his entire boxing career. We detailed at the top of the show his struggle to make the 190-pound limit. And I think really an important story here is how much Leon will have left after that struggle to make the limit.
All right, that tells us a lot. Very quickly, how do you see the fight?
Well, both fighters like to come forward. Both fighters have tremendous competitive spirit and heart. Neither has a real single punch knockout punch power, but they like to fight wars of attrition. And in a war of attrition, stamina really is the key.
All right, we'll take a look and see which fighter has the most stamina. First, the tail of the tape, a little bit misleading in the sense that Qawi is very oddly built. Some would say as wide as he is tall. The height disadvantage has not been a problem for him in many past fights. The weight you can see just about equal, though, of course, as Alex pointed out, Spinks had to come down. The reach disadvantage, again, perhaps a bit of a mirage, because Dwight Muhammad Qawi is a penetrating inside fighter. There is a good look at Qawi in his corner, once called Dwight Braxton. And here he comes to the middle of the ring to meet a fighter who doesn't back off, Leon Spinks. Round one of this scheduled 15-round bout for the WBA Junior Heavyweight Championship. And already they are mixing it up in a corner with Dwight Muhammad Qawi taking the offensive. If you you weren't with us earlier, Qawi told us in the pre-fight interview yesterday that he would bring it right to Leon.
You see Qawi working behind that jab. He doesn't put punches together as often from the outside as he did as a light heavyweight. He takes his time. He's patient. Very tough to hit. Tucks that chin in behind his left shoulder. Leon should stay away from the ropes and away from the corners like his brother Michael did in winning an easy decision over Qawi.
It's interesting to note that Qawi's style has caused many to identify him as a brawler. He says that is categorically wrong, that he is in fact a counterpuncher. Right now, Leon is taking the offensive and scoring with more punches.
Counterpunch that Qawi loves to throw is the right counterpunch. And you see Leon carrying that left very low. He is open for that right hand. As for Spinks, because of Dwight's crouching attack, the uppercut he throws so well with the right hand would be a good punch. Again, Leon in the corner.
Qawi landed a good left in that exchange, and there the right uppercut got through the defense.
Leon has been less aggressive than is his normal style here. I don't know how to read that. And either could be that he thinks he's weak at the weight and wants to pace himself. But if he was weak, I think he would come out and try to end it very quickly, not do this. This may mean that he thinks he's strong and can go the distance.
Hard to believe, for me, Alex, perhaps not for you, that it's been 8 full years now since that night in Las Vegas when he dethroned Muhammad Ali.
Right now, you'd have to say Leon just is dead at this weight. He has no legs to move away. He has very little zip in his punches at this point.
Counting down toward the latter stages of round one. So far, it has been Dwight Muhammad Qawi's round.
Low blow by Qawi. Mills Lane told him about it.
Referee is Mills Lane, a familiar figure in Nevada boxing. Now as round one comes to a close, it has been a good opening round with Dwight Muhammad Qawi. And Reno, round two just beginning. Very quickly, let's get through the rules. We've already told you that Mills Lane is the referee. There are three judges who score on a 10-point must system. The three knockdown rule is in effect. You can't be saved by the bell except in the last round, and there is no standing 8 count here. It is scheduled for 15 rounds. The ring is 20 feet by 20 feet. They are wearing 10-ounce gloves.
Both these fighters like to work on the inside. They're both very effective on the inside, but I would think the way to beat Dwight Muhammad Qawi is to move, the way Michael Spinks proved to his brother when he fought him.
So far, Leon has shown no inclination to do that. Qawi again got a right uppercut through the defense.
I'm not sure Leon has the legs to move. I think he might have to stand here and just battle it out like this, toe to toe. No mobility whatsoever in the part of either fighter. Is just eating him up on the inside. I think he's hurt a little bit right here, Jim.
Trying to jab, but as you pointed out, showing no movement away from the corner. Qawi so far has had all the advantage.
And Leon just can't wait on the inside as he is. He can't sit there and let Qawi pick him apart.
Another right hand got through. So far, Mills Lane is watching the head of Leon Spinks as Qawi rips that to it.
Leon just won't throw that uppercut inside that I think could be effective with Qawi. Qawi just putting his head on Leon's chest and working away.
Leon had 5 straight wins in 1985. And this is all Qawi right now. We're only in the second round.
Already Leon's mouth is bloody. And he is taking tremendous punishment.
The beginning of round 3 of this WBA junior heavyweight fight. Leon Spinks trying to mount an offense against Dwight Muhammad Qawi, who has clearly won the first 2 rounds. In fact, the second round, if you were paying strict attention to the 10-point must system, might have been scored by some a 10-8 round, though most judges don't do that in the absence of a knockdown. There have been no knockdowns so far, but Leon Spinks has absorbed a lot of punishment, standing against the ropes, as he is doing again right now.
Leon already breathing very, very heavily. Qawi is not exactly taking this without any punishment. He's been hit, he's thrown a lot of punches, and we're seeing a lot of his mouthpiece as well.
Incidentally, Leon, who has experienced more management changes than the Kremlin in the past few years, now works out of the Croc gym in Detroit. So familiar to all of you who are fight fans.
He is only trained by Emmanuel Stewart and Dave Collins out of that gym. He is managed by Marv Hoff and Sam LaFada. And in terms of taking this fight, Emmanuel Stewart was dead set against Leon Spinks coming down to 190 pounds. It was his opinion that Leon could not retain any strength and power at this weight. He wanted him to stay at a 200-pound heavyweight, or at a minimum, come down to 195 pounds and fight for the WBC or IBF version of this title.
So far, it looks like Emmanuel Stewart was right. We'd like to alert our local stations along the line that we'll be taking a station break at the end of this round.
Leon just took a devastating right to the to his left side from Qawi.
Qawi
is fighting really on hard here. He is hurt.
Qawi loading up the right hand time and time again and teeing off. It's remarkable that Leon can absorb this kind of punishment.
There are a number of Spinks relatives sitting right behind us. They're all shouting to Leon, box, move. They have to realize that he is just incapable physically of doing this at this time.
We're near the end of the third round of a fight which has so far been a lopsided bout in favor of the champion, Dwight Muhammad Qawi. We'll be back with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this word from your local stations. Back in Reno as round 4 gets underway. Dwight Muhammad Qawi, formerly Dwight Braxton, bearing in again on the much-punished Leon Spinks.
For the first time I saw as he came out of his corner, the champion took a deep, deep breath. He has been working very, very hard, and he may be running out of gas a little bit, lugging around those 15 extra pounds. Both fighters working very hard.
Two more uppercuts have gotten through the defense. There's another one.
Leon cannot have any leverage leaning backward on the ropes like that. He can connect, but he has to be arm punching. There's the first move Leon's made of the fight. He just spun around, got off the ropes, and scored a couple of times with some measuring jabs.
But it was at best a tentative move, and now he's backing up toward the ropes again.
But this is exactly what he wanted to do, what you're seeing right here. Whether he can sustain it or not, I don't know. A little bit of movement, a little bit of a jab. You see, he can't sustain it. He has to go back and sit on the ropes. The fight plan was to do what you just saw Leon do for 20 seconds and try to do it for 15 rounds. the Spinks family behind us giving Leon excellent advice. Let it go. Let his hands go.
Best flurry of the fight for Leon, who landed two left. And now Qawi is sticking his tongue out of it. Taunting him. You can't hurt me. And Qawi came back with a brutal right. He is laughing at Leon Spinks. But so did Muhammad Ali. That, of course, was a different time and place.
And a different Leon Spinks, yes. What a tremendous heart Leon has. We talked about the desire of both people. Leon Spinks just is extraordinary.
And Qawi, of course, like so many champions, is the classic rags to riches story. First dabbled in boxing while he was serving a 5.5-year hard time stint in the Rahway State Prison in New Jersey. Learned to box in Joe Frazier's gym in Philadelphia. Became a world champion. The only loss in his career, which remains unavenged, was that to Michael Spinks, which cost him the light heavyweight championship.
And you can believe that that is an incentive to him here today. He still wants to get Michael back in a ring.
It is still all Qawi as round four comes to a close. We'll be back. We are back at the beginning of round five in Reno, Nevada. Leon Spinks began to show sporadic signs of life in round four. But so far, if you're scoring the bout, you almost certainly would give the first four rounds to the champion, Dwight Muhammad Qawi.
Emmanuel Stewart in his corner felt that if Leon could last three or four rounds and get into the fight, he had a good chance to win. He has lasted those rounds, but he really hasn't gotten into the fight as yet.
I wonder if Stewart thought that he would absorb quite as much punishment as he has in those first four rounds.
If you're looking for a reason besides his heart as to why Leon has been able to take this amount of punishment, don't forget he's used to taking the punches of a heavyweight. He is now taking the punches of a junior heavyweight, and a man many feel is just a grown-up light heavyweight. Those punches are scoring and scoring often.
Leon still has not found a defense for the uppercut. Almost all of them are landing. Qawi dabbles occasionally with the body, but mostly he is staying upstairs.
Qawi has been down this road before. When he won the championship as Dwight Braxton against Matthew Saad Muhammad, he was in with another fighter of tremendous heart who took everything he had for many rounds. He stayed patient, he picked his shots, he took his time, and eventually won both fights with knockouts.
Qawi again, momentarily there, taunting Leon as he wiggled and dropped his hands and then poured an uppercut through the Spinks' defense.
And Leon's inability to take advantage of that is testimony to Qawi's ability to take a punch and also to Leon's inability to deliver one.
Remember, if you weren't with us earlier, 3 months ago, Leon Spinks fought at the heaviest weight at which he's ever fought, 213 pounds. Today, he fights at the lightest weight at which he's ever fought as a professional. That in itself is a difficult transition.
By 4 pounds, the lightest he's ever weighed. And he's really paying a terrible price for that battle to get down to 190 pounds.
Far has been target practice for Qawi.
Leon better start responding. I don't think he's hurt, but Mills Lane's going to take a long look at a fight as one-sided as this.
We near the end of the fifth round. I believe 5 rounds for Qawi, none for Spinks. Live in Reno, Jim Lampley with Alex Wallow, round six, WBA junior heavyweight title fight, Leon Spinks against Dwight Muhammad Qawi. Qawi, 33 years old, 25-2-1 with 14 knockouts. Spinks, 32 years old, 17-4-2 with 11 knockouts.
Qawi is old in years, but he's not really old in terms of boxing because he didn't start until he was 25 years old when he was released from Rahway State Prison in New Jersey. He had no amateur career whatsoever, as we pointed out. If you miss the first five rounds, you're looking at an instant replay. Leon Spinks on the ropes for the most part. Qawi dominating the action.
Blood continues to flow from Spinks' mouth. Qawi is so far unmarked and has at times taunted Spinks, laughed at him, stuck his tongue out at him at one point.
Dave Collins of the Croc Gym and Leon's corner watching the action. They tried in between rounds to get Leon to move, to use the jab he just used right there. But they know better than anybody. It's saying and doing it are two very, very different things.
Three solid rights, make it four solid rights and a left by Qawi. And Leon, remarkably, steps up and throws leather himself.
And he's taunting as well.
Pointed out that he has taken the punches of many good heavyweights. He is attempting to say to Qawi, I've taken the best you can throw, and I'm still here.
One thing Leon should not do is paw with the jab as he did just then. He has to make every punch count. He only has so much stamina in him. He's got to rip with every punch. Don't just let punches go. Don't throw 10 punches to land five as he did early in his career. He has to really pick his shots the way Qawi is.
This is a textbook display of inside punching by Qawi against a Leon Spinks who has mounted very little defense.
And Mills Lane is looking very, very closely. Bleeding badly again from the mouth is Leon Spinks.
You see the look of concern on Lane's face as he circles from right to left trying to get a good view of the action in the corner. This is where most of the fight has taken place. This round.
This really is. That's it. That's it. Brutal. That's it. That's it. It's all over.
Yes, sir.
Mills Lane has stopped the fight.
Yes, absolutely. He's seen quite enough. And he steps over to Leon and shakes his head and says, I'm not going to let you try to take any more of that. So Dwight Muhammad Qawi has successfully defended his championship. And in another of the many crossroads fights in his career, Leon Spinks came up short. Technical knockout, 2 minutes, 56 seconds of the sixth round. There were no knockdowns in the bout. That is a testimony to the heart and the courage of Leon Spinks.
Some idiot behind us yelled at Mills Lane. He only had 4 seconds to go in the round. Mills Lane did exactly the right thing. A look at the end. There was really nothing special in this. Mills Lane, I think, was really just looking for an excuse, waiting for a point where Leon didn't answer for a while to jump in.
Well, at this point, Leon hadn't answered for nearly a minute, I believe, except for that pawing right hand there. Bang, bang. And if you missed the early rounds, this is the way it was from the get-go. As one of the more devastating inside warriors in the sport, Dwight Muhammad Qawi showed his strength and retained his WBA Junior Heavyweight Championship. Ring announcer is Bruce Breslow. From Reno, Nevada, the Lawlor Events Center in Nevada, where Dwight Muhammad Qawi has just scored a sixth-round technical knockout over Leon Spinks to retain his WBA Junior Heavyweight title. There's the champion. He's in the ring with Alex Wallow.
Dwight, you said at the top of the show that you would jump on him right from the opening bell.
That's what I did. But, you know, he was planning on, he must have rocks in his shoes. He's a good fighter. Leon, I thought he was. I really did. Slightly shy. I said, man, going through losses and what have you, and letdowns. The man was shy. He was tricky. He was surviving and coming back. And I hit him with some shots that took a bull out of it. But he came back and he was dangerous. I had to take my hat off to him. You know, he's a fighter, man.
You were taunting him, Dwight, during the fight. When did you realize that he couldn't hurt you?
Well, first, second, one or two, he could hurt me. But he wasn't as devastated as if two hurt me. But he could hurt me. And I wasn't that careless. I was playing with him to make him expend himself. Because I figured, right, I didn't want my work to be in vain. In order for your work to work, he got to work too, you know?
Back when you were light heavyweight champion, you told me you wouldn't fight a heavyweight unless you were able to do it with a ladder. Have you changed your mind about that?
Yeah, that's when I was a light heavyweight. As I told you before, I put on more weight naturally. I carry good, and I'm strong with it. So I'm ready for the heavyweights. It don't have to be Michael. Matter of fact, I think Michael's too light for him. I think he won't be a good fight, because I'm going to crush him.
You were shouting at Evander Holyfield, the up-and-coming cruiserweight who was here at ringside, that he was next. Well, how do you assess that fight?
Well, we ain't looking so much for Evander. Evander's looking for me. So I told him that he's seen his action. Don't back out. You know what I mean? Come on, make me a payday, and I'll teach him a good lesson.
Congratulations, Dwight.
Thank you.
Leon. Lee, this has to be a tremendous disappointment to you. How much of a factor was the weight loss?
Oh, it wasn't a bad factor of weight loss. It's the point that I hesitated a little too long. When I wanted to come back, I didn't come back on time. I should have.
You told your corner that you could beat him as a heavyweight.
I can beat him as a light and a cruiserweight too.
A little bit of pre-fight hype here with Dwight Braxton and Evander Holyfield. I can tell Dwight one thing. Evander Holyfield does not have a sense of humor about that kind of a thing. And he doesn't need any more motivation. Lee, I'm sorry. Where do you go from here, Leon? This is a comeback, obviously a setback for you. What do you plan to do from this point?
I'm going to keep going forward. I can't let them get me down. They try a little hard. Take one step back, take two steps forward.
Well, whatever you do, the best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Leon. Evander, can we talk to you for 1 second? Your impressions from ringside about the champion, Dwight Muhammad Qawi.
Well, he didn't impress me more with his boxing ability. Thing is that Leon let him take the fight to him, and Leon fought his fight. So I'm not impressed with nothing. He didn't show me anything that I thought a champion should show me. But I take one fight at a time. I fight Ricky Parkey. And after that, I'll be ready to fight him, and I'll show him what a boxing is.
You're fighting Ricky Parkey here on April 6th on ABC. And after that, perhaps in July, you will fight Dwight Muhammad Qawi if everything goes according to plan. How will you fight him?
Well, I would use my boxing skill. I used to jab on. I keep the end of the jab. And I won't let him press me in the ropes. And so when he do take me in the rope, I'll show him that I can fight out the rope because I'm all around boxing. And I prove to people that I can do that. And by all this hype up, it really don't mean anything to me. I'm willing to show everybody what I can do when I get in the ring.
Good luck to you, and we'll see you on April 6th.
Thank you.
Thanks, Evander. Back to Jim Lampley.
And promoter Dan Duva has told us that on July 12, Holyfield will fight Dwight Muhammad Qawi, provided Evander gets by Ricky Parkey on April 6th here on ABC Sports in Corpus Christi, Texas. Now, we've got a long way.